You're not exhuming bodies again, are you?
No. I found a deer carcass on the farm. Perfect opportunity to study maggot growth rate.
Yeah, sounds perfect. Except, why the hell would you do that?
The age of maggots is determined by the size and number of breathing holes and variances in temperature. It gives us an estimate of when the first blowflies laid their eggs or baby maggots on the body, hence the time of death of the victim. In this case, it was 5 or 6 days.
And why are you tinkering around with insects anyway? We have no cases. Why don't you just try to enjoy your spare time?
I don't do well with spare time.
Well, maybe if you slowed your mind down once in a while. You know, go for a long walk, learn an instrument. I think I can see you with a bugle. Excuse me.
Going somewhere?
Yeah, I'm taking Diana from the records office out dancing.
Oh, another budding romance.
Well, let's just call it excellent use of my spare time. Except I think Diana's gonna have to wait to another night.
What is your brother Robert doing in Kansas City?
Will, Mrs. Vaughn. So good to see you.
Is it?
You're looking hale and hearty, William.
Yeah, thanks, Robert. And you're looking like you.
You're probably wondering what I'm doing here in Kansas City.
We are.
I've been charged with undertaking the annual field office reviews this year.
Wait, you're telling me my own brother gets to grill me on how I do my job?
There'll be no grilling, Will. It's all very routine, and as I've discovered, somewhat stultifying.
Maybe you could use a drink. I know I could.
Another time. I'm for the pillow, and we all have a busy day tomorrow.
Good night, Robert.
Good night, Mrs. Warren. Will.
I don't get it. George Banks always conducts her reviews as Alan's right-hand man.
You're right. It's very odd. But, you know, he's my brother. Maybe he'll go easy on us.
You think so? George Banks is tough but fair. Your brother, on the other hand, he doesn't care for me at all.
He seemed like a perfect gentleman right now. Didn't even mention that you look like a dirt farmer.
Will, I'm telling you, something's up. This won't be routine. Unwell.
Oh, can't tell if it's the ox cheeks or you talking about maggots. What is all this?
These are all the case files I've sent to the Chicago office.
You are really worried about this review.
I'm worried that it's your brother doing them.
Well, don't. He's just toadying to the old man.
William! Mrs. Warren, you look cleaner.
Thank you. Why isn't George Banks conducting the reviews?
Gout. Can barely make it to the privy, let alone travel. So I badgered and cajoled Father into allowing me to do the reviews. He can be endlessly stubborn, as you know.
Well, that'll never change.
In many ways, our father is an immovable object, don't you think?
I do.
Ah, he's right on time. I like to be thorough with my reviews. Talk to as many of your associates as possible.
I guess it makes sense he would want to talk to John.
Mr. Bell, when you first met Mrs. Warren, what was your impression?
That she didn't mince her words.
You move and I shoot.
But she quickly realized she could trust me and even let me fix her gun.
Well, see, the wedge pin is loose. The chamber and the barrel have moved forward, and the hammer can't get a good hit at the percussion cap. There. Should be fine.
You can put your hands down.
Thank you.
You would be?
John Bell.
And when did you realize Mrs. Warren and Mr. Pinkerton were detectives?
When she told me who they were.
The men that were in the house. I work with them. Alan and William Pinkerton.
Pinkerton? The detective agency.
You've heard of us?
Sure have.
But Alan Pinkerton's an avowed abolitionist and a loyal friend of John Brown.
Well, I often find myself in unusual and sometimes dangerous situations. I wouldn't want you to get hurt, John.
Thank you, but I can take care of myself.
I'm glad to hear it.
If you ever need anything, you can count on me.
Thank you.
Give me the details on the time you went undercover with the troop of black soldiers.
We suspected one of the soldiers was a killer, so I called for a license inspection to look for any injuries that were sustained during the attack. When I saw one of the soldiers sneak out of the inspection, I thought we had our killer.
What, you just come in here like that?
You didn't comply with inspection.
What are you gonna do about it?
Report you. Now get your shirt off, soldier. She wasn't the killer, but discovering the soldier was a woman helped us solve the case.
But on the other hand, you had an unpleasant encounter with Confederate General Sterling Price.
I guess I did.
You know what this is, boy? Sulfuric acid. You know what it does? Now imagine what it does to the eyes. Spirit is upon me, boy. Fortunately for you, you can keep those eyes of yours. Just don't ever tell me no again. A little correction for a minor.
It wasn't long after that that General Price died from the cholera.
What's wrong with him?
I don't know.
Any idea how he contracted it?
I was just at the hotel. Overheard the doctor say Price might have the cholera.
But how? He traveled with his own supply of water.
Which he left unattended. So I'm told.
You mean someone put cholera-infected water in his private supply?
It's possible, I guess. But with cholera, half die and half recover. So, it's really up to the Lord. Let him decide how to deal with a man like Price.
So you deny poisoning General Price?
I do.
And do you deny stealing money from the woman who raised you? The New York businesswoman, Marm McGoldrick?
Marm McGoldrick was a thief, and I don't deny. But I tried to give her her money back.
It was so good to see you yesterday.
Stop with the charm. We're well past that.
Can't I ask how you are? And how you been these past 10 years?
I'm a new man, living an honest life.
That's funny. Stealing money from me to start an honest life. I sense a contradiction there.
It was my only way out.
Angry as I was, I had to admire your cunning.
I'm here now to make it right. There's a deed to my farm that I paid for with the cash. The rest in coins. That's for Aldred and for me.
Robert was insinuating you were a thief and murderer?
I guess. He didn't say anything else.
What is he up to? Oh, look who's next.
I was what you Americans call a bounty hunter. I hired the Pinkertons to help me find out who killed my partner.
I tracked the killer down and confronted him.
The Pinkertons convinced me to let the killer face American justice. Meaning, I failed my mission to bring him back to Japan to face justice there.
So you stayed in America and accepted the Pinkerton offer to apprentice with the agency?
Yes.
But once you joined the agency, you began clashing with law enforcement.
Maybe you should have some tea.
Annalee, another bottle. If you didn't stop me, I could have had his confession by now.
Or you'd have been arrested for murder.
Judge could be trying him as we speak, and we could hang him before dinner, and then I would have a wonderful dinner of boiled duck and chum cakes. Annalee!
Kenji, he's cut off. You take him back to his office, let him sleep it off.
Okay, Sheriff.
Annalee, honey.
Sheriff.
Give me a bottle!
Get him out now!
You must rest, Sheriff Logan.
Rest? Rest. There's no damn rest. She's dead.
You even interfered with an arrest.
When I beat you into your grave! Shallow grave. Sound familiar?
You be dead and you arrest.
I won't arrest myself, I promise.
Logan!
Ah! Ah! Damn it, Kenji!
Sheriff! Tell me about the time you pulled a gun on Kate and Will.
I was delirious.
Yatsuakamada.
Kenji.
Okay. Hikasteoken.
Somebody gonna stop him or not?
Sueto omae no seida.
Kenji, no!
Your actions endangered everyone in that room.
I told you, I was not responsible for my actions.
A good Pinkerton agent is always responsible for his actions. Now, if you'll excuse me.
Kenji, you look upset.
Robert Pinkerton twists my words. No matter what I say, he makes it bad. I feel like I've betrayed you.
Well, according to Kenji, Robert has a hidden agenda.
Well, my brother's always been secretive. Heck, I know more about you.
I should hope not. But if Kenji's right, we have to be careful.
What's he talking to her about?
Please, sit a moment. I'd like to ask you a few questions, if you don't mind.
I don't see why not.
You must see quite a bit of Will, given that he lives in the hotel.
Oh. Well, he makes his presence known.
Yes, he always was a bit of a lad.
A bit of a lad?
Pinkerton. William Pinkerton.
Oh, my. A Pinkerton man.
Do you have a first name?
Diana.
That is a beautiful name. It means heavenly, you know.
I didn't.
And very appropriate, if I may say.
I'm Rebecca Harper.
Rebecca. It's a beautiful name. It means captivating, you know.
I'm named for the wife of Isaac and the mother of Esau and Jacob.
Oh, you're married? Children?
No, they're biblical figures. I am unmarried.
Oh. Oh, thank heavens. Want something to warm you up?
Alcohol is the devil's drink. It clouds the mind, separates us from what's holy.
Oh, come on. Missionaries aren't allowed to have some fun?
What troubles you, Will Pinkerton?
Your certainty.
I call it faith.
Well, what troubles you, Miss Harper?
You.
Well, let me know if you change your mind about that drink. It's gonna get cold.
I take fire, hits him in the shoulder. On his way down, he fires and grazes me. So anyway, what about you? What's your name? I don't know anything about you at all, really. But,
No.
What? You can't leave a man alone for a second, can you?
I figured it out.
You figured out that I'm busy. Good.
And what about you, Miss Webb? Did you and Will ever have a, dalliance?
I'll have whatever you're pouring, sweetheart.
Your tab is running a little high.
Well, I could always put that off.
You know what, Sugar? There's a black man outside who wants to talk to you. He says it's urgent.
Do me a favor. See that stern-looking gentleman over there? Just go dump that beer on him so I can get out of here.
Anything for those lips.
Oh! Hit me again, beautiful.
Now, why is it we all look gorgeous when the drinks are free?
Well, I must admit, I am beginning to enjoy certain of Kansas City's charms.
Tonight, the whiskey's free, but the women, they'll cost you.
Mm. All right, let's go.
I can't.
Come on.
I'm working.
One dance will not hurt you. Hey, heads up.
Hey, what?
Good morning.
Well, sir, we shared some good times together, but not what I think you're implying.
You sent a complaint to the Chicago office a few months ago. Said the Pinkertons were interfering with an investigation.
Frankly, I've lost track of the number of times your agency has interfered with my investigations.
Come on, Sheriff. I've seen you work. You could use a little help.
Oh, from her?
May we please return to the pressing matter?
Fine. Oh, I knew you two would try to weasel in on this.
The governor has hired us to assist in this case, given its delicate nature.
I can be delicate, too.
I'd like to see that.
Okay, so the morphine caused him to fall off his horse and freeze, or maybe he took too much of it and it killed him. Either way, John Doe is demised by his own deed.
Any needle marks?
Yep. Left arm. That enough for you pinks?
Probably another poor veteran.
He was drinking at the Buffalo Head like nobody's business.
No papers?
No.
No money?
No. And do you have any more annoying questions?
No.
Good.
According to our case files, you once assisted our people during a standoff in this saloon?
That's what that says? Assisted? How about I saved their lives?
You know what we want. Give us that murdering bastard. Everything is fine. Oh, well, looky here. The little lady's joining us. Now we're real scared.
Well, you ought to be scared now, pal. Numbers are getting even. Lou and Kate would be sleeping in pine boxes right now if it wasn't for me.
So you have doubts as to their competence?
Well, wait a minute. I wasn't trying to suggest that they're bad agents, just that we bail each other out if need be.
You're wasting your time. I've got that sheriff in the palm of my hand. No one gonna believe.
That's where you're wrong. I heard the whole thing, Slayton. You and your friend here are under arrest for the murders of Burt Grove and Carrie O'Brien.
And the attempted murder of me.
All right, that too.
What kind of sheriff are you, letting a woman do your work for you?
He had it coming.
Job performance is not the only criterion for taking the measure of a Pinkerton agent. A respect for local lawmen is paramount, as is an unwavering moral character. Will is not shone in the latter regard, for example.
Mr. Pinkerton, If you were here trying to tear them down, I can assure you I'm not going to help you do it. Have they been a thorn in my side? Hell yes, but Kate and Will are two of the bravest lawmen I've ever met. Hope you got that down there in your criteria. You just put that in your notes, huh?
So, how's life back in Chicago?
The usual. Mother's complaining about the family business. Your father's getting older, she says. Wants him to quit the field work. Oh, the rows they have. He can be quite tyrannical.
Now you know why I moved 400 miles away. You want to tell me why you're digging into my private life? Anna Lee told me.
Just wanted to see how you were getting along. I know you don't like to talk about that sort of thing, but Mother keeps asking when you're going to find a girl and get married.
Well, you can tell her she'll know as soon as I know.
Let's talk about Mrs. Warren. 6 months ago, you wrote George Bangs and formally protested Kate Warren's assignment to Kansas City.
Yes, well, Kate doesn't exactly care much for making first impression.
Father never paid out to rent me a house.
I thought you liked the Dubois Hotel.
I do. It's the principal of it.
Oh, so you do have principles.
If you're such a good detective, how come I've never heard of you?
Maybe because you're not such a good detective? What are you doing here?
Rescuing you.
Do I look like I need rescuing? This is all part of my plan.
What the hell it was?
Fine. Don't believe me.
I won't.
Good.
Good?
Just listen. Roddy, he just left. He went after somebody named Crowell. Does that ring a bell?
Crowell? No.
I think it has to do with the something big you were talking about. Let's go.
Horse is this way.
What about her investigative skills?
Well, she's great at the science stuff.
The Marsh test. Add zinc and acid.
Hope you don't store this stuff in your pantry.
You should come over for dinner sometime.
No, thanks.
I'm a good cook.
My nose would beg to differ.
Burning this should leave a silvery deposit. Arsenic.
I don't see anything.
Exactly. It's not arsenic.
So it was strychnine.
Well, we have to test.
So test?
There is no test.
Is this a test?
I looked it up in one of my medical books. The formula for predicting a woman's height, it's based off her femur.
Her femur?
The thigh bone.
You take the length of the bone, multiply it by 2.6, then add 25.5.
Science.
Worse. It's arithmetic.
It indicates that she was 5'5". I calculated the thickness of her muscle tissue and skin, and then I formed clay around the skull.
Why on earth do that?
To arrive at the conjecture of what she might look like, of course.
You just thought this up?
I did.
And, how was she at the chase?
Well, the woman has no fear. I'll give her that.
Stop! I warned you, stop.
You seem to have changed your opinion of her.
She did save my life.
Foxglove? Isn't that some kind of poison?
Don't worry, it'll wear off soon. But you know what won't wear off?
What's that?
Oh, drowning. There.
Let him go, or the next one's in your heart, Slayton. Will, are you all right?
Indeed. Mrs. Warren appears to be a first-rate Pinkerton.
Indeed, she is. Is that it?
For you? Yes.
He sang your praises.
You're kidding. Robert can't stand me. I mean, you said it yourself. He dislikes female detectives.
Okay, that was a long time ago, but people can change their minds.
Even you?
Well, I was referring to Robert, but yes, me too. I can change my mind, can't I?
Look, what you two think of me is not really the point. Robert's got something up his sleeve, and I'm gonna find out what that is.
Here's your chance.
I'll answer all of your questions, but quite frankly, I believe my record speaks for itself.
Actually, Mrs. Warren, I'd like to hear your thoughts on my brother.
What do you want to know?
How you work together, how you judge his capabilities. I understand you are not overly eager to become his partner.
True. Our working styles are very different.
Told me to sign or hang. I remember that part real clear.
Well, good news. Someone's missing a saddle horn.
Could be anyone.
That was mostly my point. Have you two narrowed down our list of
suspects? Railroads, neighbors, basically anyone with a vested interest in rail
expansion. So you've narrowed it down to pretty much everyone.
I'm surprised the saddle horn you picked up hasn't cracked the case wide open for us.
You two work together.
Well, you obviously saw him.
I was at the Dubois last night. There were these four pretty ladies. One of them slid him an envelope stuffed with money. There's lots of it, too. I think I'll go talk to them.
What, the pretty ladies?
Yeah.
I think I'll join you.
Afraid of that?
Well, who's paying us?
Who cares? They're pretty. So, does your plan to attend costume balls?
They're disguises.
Well, why so many? All you need is a story and a smile.
Easy for Pinkerton men. A woman, as always, must do more.
We have to find Buckner.
We? I never agreed to protect him.
My father put you here to watch me. Every time I mess up, you failed. But don't worry. I might be able to save your bacon.
But I know now that he was never the child I took him to be. That was my unfair judgment. He was growing into his own skin, finding his way. At times, he could be exasperating. But still, through it all, we've managed to forge a strong working relationship.
See, we can agree on something. It's not gonna kill you.
What? Look, I'm going to attend to Belle and see what I can learn from her. I suggest you do the same with her father. Will, be discreet with your questions. Act like you know less than you do. Act vacant.
Yeah, be myself. Thanks, Kate.
Took the words right out of my mouth. Quite honestly, most of Will's detective work is first rate. Whereas my skills tend to favor deductive reasoning. We need to sift the truth from Robert's lies.
Sounds like fun. What's your plan?
I thought we could wire Alan for a list of warrants from Indiana, Louisiana, and Virginia for a man matching Burgess' description, but with the name Edmund.
We don't have that much time, though. The troop's pulling out tomorrow.
Then we dispatch an agent to Dubuque and locate the bartender that called Robert Ed.
It's still not enough time.
Then what do you propose we do? Will's investigative skills are more direct.
How about this?
Hey, Ed! It's you, right? You're Ed?
That works, too.
It appears Will has finally found a release for his impulsiveness.
You could say that, but it's an attribute, to be sure.
And what about his undercover work?
Will has some natural abilities in that arena.
La, 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 la.
Focus on the one sound repeated five times, slowly and clearly.
Sorry, what is this supposed to be helping with?
Vocal tuning. Your voice is your instrument. Again?
La, la, la.
Excuse me.
I'm sorry, I choked on my water. Did that ever happen to you?
No. His work sounds positively stellar.
Robert, don't for one minute think that your brother's work isn't up to snuff. He's taken a punch from me more than once. His skills at neutralizing conflict are exemplary.
Oh.
Rudy, stop!
Get out of my way, Pinkerton! You don't want to kill anyone.
Yes, I do.
You just want your life back. Give him my gun.
Will is strong and courageous.
That's good enough.
He's an agent that never backs away from danger.
Oh, wait, hang on. Just one more load so the buzzers don't get me, all right?
Comports himself well in a tense situation.
You certainly extol his virtues.
I give credit where it's due.
You've done well bringing him along. You should be proud. He's ready to go out on his own, don't you think?
What do you mean?
Well, simply that he's acquired the skills necessary to take on responsibility as needs be.
If need be, are you splitting us up?
Of course not. This is a review, Mrs. Warren. Plain and simple.
I'm not so sure about that.
It's the same one I've conducted in Boston, Philadelphia, Washington, Baltimore. There's no need to get emotional.
Really? Boston, Philadelphia, Washington, and Baltimore? All Pinkerton bureaus with female agents, am I right?
That would be correct.
Are you trying to drum the women out of this agency?
Like I said, it's just a review.
If you are, let me remind you that your father hired me and promoted me because of my good work. He also created the female bureau and appointed me to run it.
Has it ever occurred to you, Mrs. Warren, that even my father makes mistakes?
If you're plotting to close the female bureau, you can expect a fight.
I believe he lied to my face, my own brother. It'll all be very routine, Will. Guess you were right.
Would have been happy to be wrong.
But how does he expect to get away with cutting out the entire female bureau? Our father would have his hide if he tried that.
But that's what I find intriguing. How does he plan to get away with it?
There's only one way to find out.
Suppose you just had a talk with Mrs. Warren?
You don't get to be casual with me. Not while you're stabbing Kate in the back and every other woman our father's hired.
You tend to react in the moment, Will. You were never very adept at taking the long view.
Would you drop the act? Tell me what you're really doing in Kansas City.
The Pinkerton National Detective Agency needs to grow, or else it'll stagnate and become irrelevant. Our dear father is content with the status quo. We have too many agents investigating too many smaller cases. Murders, thefts, fraud, and the like. The financial return on these cases is, to coin a phrase, small time. If, indeed, we get paid at
all. Solving murders and bringing justice to grieving people is small time? That's important work, Robert.
Work best left to local law enforcement. We need to think bigger. By focusing all of our resources on more lucrative endeavors. By only concentrating on corporations, banks, industry, railroads.
But Father will never agree to that. He thinks about people, not just institutions.
Which is why I need your help. George Bangs agrees with me, as does our Uncle Robert. With you, I have all the support I need to overrule Father.
You're talking about a coup? To push Father out? Not to mention the entire female bureau?
Oh, Will, forget about the female bureau. I'm sure Kate Bourne is a competent agent, but I'm talking about turning a somewhat profitable enterprise into a fortune. And our female agents are nothing but a distraction from that goal.
Try explaining that to Father.
Which is why we need to push him out. Will, imagine not having to take orders from that stubborn tyrant of a man. I'll admit, I volunteered to conduct this review in part to assess Mrs. Warren's value to the agency. But I also needed to know if you've come of age as an agent, and if you were ready to join me at the helm. I now know that you are, and that gives me great pleasure. Think about it, Will. I'll need your decision soon.
Tell you something. It's about me. Sit down.
Really? The mysterious Mrs. Warren is gonna tell me something about herself? Okay.
Let me get settled.
Your father invented the art of spying in this country. I was his first female agent.
I'm very aware of that.
Sterling Price brought on a new kind of war. I mean, he slaughtered people. Black people especially. Stole their children, sold or hanged them.
And?
Your father had a mission, one which I willingly volunteered for. And if all it took to stop Price was a compromise of honor, it would have been a sin not to do it.
And whose honor are we talking about?
Will, you know very well whose honor. Please just, please listen. I put myself in the path of an officer and General Price's staff.
Lieutenant Harris you spoke of. Charlie?
Yes. He was young, passionate. The thing was not hard to do. I quickly gained access to the general's supply routes, orders of battle, which I relayed to the Union forces, and they defeated Price at Yucca and Corinth.
That's good work.
Cost the general 6,222 men.
That's war, Kate.
Price shot Charlie. I'm sure he died, believing it had all been a mistake, that I would never use him in such a way. Well, towards the end, I know I shouldn't, but I had feelings for him. I really did.
And that's why you're after Price.
People hurt each other for specific reasons. Greed, anger, passion, but Price? He had and has no reasons. He's simply evil. Now, I may not be a woman of God, but I will not abide the devil.
When you told me about your history with General Sterling Price, that was a painful admission for you. Why'd you tell me?
Because I knew that you would listen without judgment.
Listen, Kate. If you weren't a Pinkerton, what would you want to be?
Why are you asking me?
I'm just curious. Have you ever thought about starting a family or getting remarried?
The Pinkertons is my family.
Mrs. Warren. William, can I have a word with you?
Anything you have to say, you can say it in front of Kate.
Have you considered my proposal?
Your proposal? To betray Kate and our father? To cut them both out?
It is no betrayal to build upon what Alan began. I intend to enhance his legacy.
Well, you won't enhance it with me.
Isn't this the chance we've been waiting for, Will? The chance for you and I to run our business our way?
Your way means intrigue and betrayal. It's no way to run a business, Robert.
Very disappointed with your lack of initiative, Will.
That's because you know your plan goes nowhere without me.
Changes are coming. Not today, perhaps, but soon.
I'll tell you what, Robert. You drop this ridiculous notion, and I won't tell Father about it. Otherwise, you'll be the one to face the wrath of our so-called tyrant.
He'll come to your senses one day, William.
If you don't tell your father, I will.
No, you won't. I know my brother, Kate. The threat of exposure is going to keep him quiet.
For now, he'll be looking to strike again when the time is right.
We'll make sure that time never comes.
On the next Pinkertons.
What kind of surprises, Mr. Pinkerton?
When man is dead and other people are in danger.
I can't help but wonder if I'm the next target.
He's hiding something.
I see you found the murder weapon.
Let him hang.
What is this about? You have to tell me.
There's too much at stake.
What kind of monster are you?
You don't know what I am.